Hello, my name is Juliana Baioni, and I will be singing Donde, lieta, uscí from La Bohème by Puccini.
So that what's happening with the rest of your body doesn't matter quite as much.
Okay.
If that makes sense. Well, how does vowel, for you, how does vowel and breath, or rather resonant space and breath, relate? Or are they related?
Well, one thing I've been trying to work more is deeper, which then consequently I think makes this higher. And often when I get too nervous, it grabs here, and so then it becomes flatter.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I have this crazy theory, and all the voice teachers in here are gonna like write me off. I think the lift of the soft palate is less important, is not that important. What is important about the lift of the soft palate is that sympathetically encourages the larynx to settle. And that's Limperti. Limperti said that. I thought I made that up, and then I was reading Limperti, I was like, they said it right there, I didn't make it up. So that feeling of, it's interesting, you're talking about being grounded in the body, getting the soft palate up, and what I think it all actually goes to is that space here, mm-hmm. right behind the base of the tongue. Because the soft palate, if it's like really forward, really down, or really forward and really nasal, like then it can kind of screw things. But honestly, like a little bit of soft palate opening isn't always a bad thing. Mm-hmm. But a high larynx is not inherently bad, but for the genre that you're singing,
yes.
won't allow you to use the resonance strategy you want. Your A flat on double, stunning. Can we harness that for the G of Savoy and the B flat of Ricordo? Mm-hmm. Do you mind, would it be awful to jump in just on or whatever the A flat is? Everyone now knows I know. So if you're going, what time does the vet close? Sorry, I'm referencing things from behind. I don't know how many people we have. But if you're thinking about your grocery list,
yeah.
That doesn't matter if the sound is what it needs to be. Yeah, so paint by number real quick.
Oh,
Now it's so rude that you have to go ari, that it's ah, because ah is just a booger. Like, but B, I would say choose when you're gonna switch back from ah, or rather ah, when do you go back into the pocket? Is it on re or is it on the C D flat of ah?
I'm trying to do it on the ah, the C D flat.
Yeah, because the D flat's kinda high to go ah. Could you think, or could you sing that on, I'm singing on, like love.
Love.
Yeah, I call that the love boat. I don't know. You, yeah, you know this. This high school's like love boat.
Oh, I know.
Can you try that?
The C.
And then can we do for some, my brain is not working in a regular key. Thank you. This goes re, and then the re, you're gonna already have to modify it because it's high.
But I'm changing the vowel? Or you want me to re? Change the vowel?
Yeah, you need to. You have to.
I mean for the A?
No.
Ricorda?
Yeah, so modify that traveling down the front of your face.
Okay.
And I know it's like ricordo, and it's like oh, but you can cheat a little and make more oh. But bring it down, gather it down the front. That's going to help you keep the space open in the back in theory.
Okay. From a ricordo?
Yeah. Resonating frequency of the pitch, because it's an A flat to A flat. Granted, we're just doing B flat.
Okay.
But if you use that A flat vowel, an octave lower, the overtone, an octave above, the second harmonic, first overtone, will line up with the resonance, and you're going to get a little boost. And then your breath's just going to go. Woo. So could you do
one thing?
Yeah.
This ties in to the earlier thing we were saying. Is again. Ignore the dynamic. This is Puccini.
Yeah.
You need to be singing a rich mezzo forte.
Mm-hmm.
Do not try to pull back from this.
Okay.
It's so much lower that it'll be quieter on its own.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
When he's saying give all the same space, yes, and don't try to. Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So can you imagine you're singing that A flat? sorry. Yeah. Ah, but that's a completely different vowel. And what if it wasn't?
Uh-huh. Suddenly so much more open because you used to have it in a little track.
Okay.
Right? And now it's gonna go. Can we do it again?
Yo, yeah, please. So some singers kind of have superpowers. Craig has a lot of these superpowers where we'll like work and I'll just go, oh yeah, that's just that thing you can do that like if I tried to do, I'd blow my voice out in like 20 seconds. And like you just get to sing that way because you're just able to do it. You can bring in this steely quality in your middle range, which is one of your superpowers. And that's awesome. But it's not necessarily what you want to use all the time.
Sure.
And so if this is marked pianissimo, keeping the steel out and just using the whirly-poo resonance that you're finding now, then, like Craig was saying, the phrase gets shaped naturally, where it's pianissimo because of where it's set, because that's what Puccini does so well.
Uh-huh.
So if you were singing, like, Turandot, and you needed to, like, then bring in the steel.
Yeah.
But for this moment, let it stay vulnerable.
Okay.
Yeah. And it's going to mess with your breath. And it's going to be scary, and it's going to destabilize things for a little while, but learning is messy. And because, you know, you're able to tweak these things so quickly that in, you know, in a week of just sort of laying down a track of like, okay, this is one of the options, you'll find how that calibrates for you. The last thing, unless Craig, you want to do some more stuff, last thing I'd say is love every note, love your pickups.
Okay.
So what vowel do you like to sing on an E flat?
E.
You like E. Great. Could you love that then?
Yeah.
And prep it behind the rolled R.
Are you saying to make it a little longer? Because I was worried I'd make the pickup too long. I was kind of...
You have more flexibility. You have diva. You have diva allowance.
Okay.
So when you get a dotted 16th or whatever, you get to stretch that baby.
The other thing that's free is the consonant. So you can do and you'd be in time.
Yeah.
Granted, you have to get off needle at some point, but you could do a full eighth note of
okay.
Nobody's gonna say, well, she was early, or she held that note too long.
Okay.
Consonants, when you precede the beat, are free. Could you try that? So we find a if you like. Yeah.
Is that the E flat?
Singing the mask, they crank their larynx up and they go, ah! So it has to go up first and then forward.
Yes.
Which, yeah. Can you tell me a little bit about where you are in your journey as a singer?
That is a great question. Okay, I started singing very young.
Yeah.
But my mom says I didn't sing in tune until I started taking flute lessons in fifth grade. I started taking professional classical lessons when I was 16.
Yeah.
I chose not to do voice in college, which everyone was very mad at me about, and did flute performance for a bachelor's, arts management for my master's, and then came to California to do a vocal performance certificate, and I've been studying with Dr. Rajin Lee at La Sierra University. The pandemic hit, I did a virtual recital in 2021, and I am now back or trying to get myself out there.
Yeah.
Finally. And it's been a journey for sure.
Yeah, well, do it. And give yourself permission. So one thing I take away from that is you started singing young, you took time off, and you came back with it.
Mm-hmm.
A lot changes here mm-hmm. in that time. And stuff that might have been risky when you were like 16, now you have to do. Like for me, as a scrawny little bass, who for a long time, was just too young for the rep I was singing, I at some point had to go, no, I'm 35, damn it, I get to go, oh, like that, I have to do that, otherwise my voice doesn't work.
Uh-huh.
And what, if I tried to do it when I was younger, like it might have been too much. You've got, your voice is mature enough that you can give yourself permission to just sing the way your voice wants to, that might feel almost even over the top.
Mm-hmm.
Be over the top so long as your voice says, ooh, yeah, we like that.
Okay.
Listen to your voice and be an opera diva.
Yeah, I would use the word that you're ready for the stage of abandon.
Mm.
Where, in these lines, like, al solitario nido, when you, if you try to temper it at all,
okay.
It just needs to be completely, you are ready to completely unleash it for, and instead of having that stress of like, well, when I go up to this other beat, I better shape it, I better overthink it. Right now, you've got the strength where you just, you're like, oh,
I want to just keep playing with your voice, but we should move on.
Yeah.
Can you just for me one more time? Because I'm greedy. Can we go back to revisit that? And you're just like Craig was saying, take a risk and if it goes, it'll be better than what I just did.
I've been trying to play more the character too, understanding what she's saying, who she's talking to, so that'll maybe help me also with the abandoning into
yes.
it.
Yeah. And look at what's animando e crescendo forte. Blum, 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 blum. Let her rip.
Okay.
Is that stentorian? Is that what stent means?
Yeah.
I don't know. Anyway, let's try it.
Wasn't as connected.
Right.
Yeah.
Because you tried to quiet it.
Yes.
You're the diva.
Yes.
You're the diva. You let it all go, and then you saw sense.
It was the crying.
Oh, good. Then just finish it. Adios, sense.